Hey, and welcome to our session today about the three omnichannel tips B2B can steal from B2C. My name is Asse Britt, and I am the VP of Growth Marketing at Terminus. For those of you not familiar with Terminus, we are an account-based marketing platform where you can run multi-channel programs for your full funnel, from new logo acquisition to pipeline acceleration to customer expansion. I'm actually located in the Washington, D.C. area, and I am a baseball softball mom, so I spent a lot of my time out there on the fields, and I'm a lover of warm weather. I'm originally from Florida, and I love the sand and the sea and the sun. So for today's brief session here, we're going to talk about omnichannel. You know, what is it? What some of the top three channels are that you should be thinking about that you can snag from B2C, and then why you should be thinking about omnichannel. So let's get started about what does omnichannel, you know, really mean. It's about understanding exactly who your audiences are, acknowledging that B2B buying is not linear. I think we're all pretty familiar with that. I know there have been studies that have been done that have kind of validated the fact that a lot of the research has been done before people even start to engage with you. And then delivering the right message at the right time. So I think that is just smart marketing anyway for anybody. And then engaging your audiences on their terms. So a lot of these buyers want to talk to you when they're ready, not necessarily when you're ready to talk to them. So I think to get started, we really have to kind of think about data. And everything is kind of rooted in data, both from B2C to B2B. We have to make sure that we start everything on a really solid foundation of data. And how that kind of translates, you know, from the B2C world to the B2B world is in many different ways. So there's B2C. A lot of companies are focused on demographics because that's important, you know, to who they're trying to target, being gender, race or household income, family lifestyle, all that. And then how that translates to B2B is more on firmographics. So are there particular industries that you're trying to reach, company sizes, you know, what kind of growth and stuff they have, and geographies. On B2C too, for buying behavior, that information is really important. And then on the B2B side, that kind of translates to technographic information. And by what technographic information, by what I mean is, what does their technology stack look like? If you are a tech company, SaaS company, and you may have a product that aligns very well with other customers or prospects that have a particular tech stack. You may have specific APIs that work well with their products and things like that. So you may narrow down your list of targeted accounts based on what that looks like. And then the next one is browsing history. So for B2C, there's a lot of data obviously at their disposal that they use to kind of identify people that are kind of up their buying cycle. And on B2B, we use intent signals. Now, intent signals can be first-party intent signals, and they can be third-party intent signals. And by first-party, what I mean is who is visiting your website? Which accounts are visiting your website? Are you seeing surges? Is the frequency of how often that they are visiting, is that spiking? Are they visiting lower funnel pages like demos and trials and case studies? So those are all the types of intent signals that you can use from a first party basis that will show you where their readiness to engage in a conversation. And then there's third party intent signals. We personally use information at Terminus from Bombora on keywords and topics that are closely in line with our business. And we also work with third-party review sites like G2, where we get information on intent, again, in certain categories or competitors that people are searching. We kind of marry all that information together to kind of get an understanding of a particular account's intent. And then the next couple ones, there's psychographic information and observed engagement, which you have both in B2B and in B2C. All right, so let's dig in to the top three channels, which is the meat of the presentation today. So the first one I wanted to talk about is display or digital advertising. Display advertising has been around obviously for quite a while, since the beginning of the internet. That's how advertising really kind of started on there. But when you look at it like from a B2B perspective, it can have lots of benefits to it. One is account targeting capabilities. So if you have the right platform, you can really make sure your display ads are being served to the most important accounts that you want. And it's not just the list of accounts. You can also filter and get deeper within those accounts by adding different criteria as the job function that they're in. So say you have a product that that is for the accounting and finance department. You can make sure that you're only, showing your ads to people who are in that particular job function within the accounts that you want to talk to. You can also do it by job level. If you are hitting the C-suite or you're hitting someone that, like a director, VP level or a manager level, you can also add those types of filtering options. It can be very efficient. You can set up budget controls on a daily basis or on a campaign basis. And then the efficiency is also on the management side too. You can automate these display ads. And what I mean by that is we actually run different sets of ad sets that are based on an account's stage and an opportunity journey. So if they're in a certain stage, they'll get certain ad suite. And as they move based on how that account changes in our CRM, they will then move to the next level of display ad suites. So that way you can make sure that you're hitting the right message at the right time and having those validation points and stuff like that that you want. It's also measurable. You can measure the impressions, the reach, the click-throughs, everything. And it's also personable. So you can use display ads for retargeting. You can also get down to like that one-to-one type of ads by using variable fields, especially for ones that are like the accounts that are like your high strategic accounts that you want to have that layer of customization. And display can be multiple use cases. You can use it for brand awareness, you can use it for nurturing, and you can also use it for more of that direct conversion. So next one is email. So email has been around for quite some time. I remember with the rise of when social media came on board and everybody was like, email is dead. No one's gonna be using email anymore. It's all moving over to social. We just quite haven't seen that. I think there's a place for social media marketing and there's a place for email marketing. Some of the benefits, with email is you're able to get highly targeted. And those are just some examples I listed here with the company geography, all that kind of stuff. And it's a highly engaged audience. And by what I mean by that is usually you're emailing or you should be emailing people that either you've gotten permission to email or you've had some past engagement with them. So they're in your marketing database because of some type of prior response they've had or relationship that they've had or they've opted in. So you already know that they know who you are at some level. It's definitely cost effective, it's measurable, and it can be personal and customizable. So for email, this is beyond just like, sending emails from your marketing automation platform. You can also, what I'm referencing here too, is do email signature advertising within your emails. And I have some examples of that coming up. But it's a really highly effective way to kind of get your message out and use it for educational purposes, nurturing, and also conversions. But the beauty of it, I think, is that it's something that the marketing department can control. So you can do it based on the different kinds of segments that you have. It can be, like I said, geography. So say you're having a regional event and you want every outbound email coming out from your company in that region to invite people to your booth at a conference that you're going to. Or if you're having your own hosted event, making sure that they know about it and they're being invited to it. Or it could be more of people from a certain account that you want to make sure they're getting the same. Say you have a content stream specifically for them that you want them to see. You can also promote that in an email signature banner to ensure that every email, outbound email that's going to that account is going to see the same type of display ad in the emails. All right, and then the last one is chat. So we've seen chat in B2C for quite some time. It's such a useful tool when it comes to resolving customer service kind of issues and questions. Also, a lot of e-commerce companies use chat when people are browsing and looking to purchase something, and they may be getting stuck, and they can offer some help or guide them in the right direction. But some of the benefits that we see, and especially for B2B, is it allows you to have that immediate connection and conversations with people. So they're coming to you, and you can, you know, prompt them to have a conversation to see how you can help. You can also do self-guided paths on chats. So allowing them, when they open the chat bot, to kind of get to where they want to go quicker. So it might be to have a conversation, but maybe they don't want to have a conversation. They're just looking for some resources. And it allows you to filter low quality traffic. And the reason I put this on is I had a little story, a case here, where at one of my previous companies, we had a page, it was an informational page that got tons and tons of traffic. And it wasn't a highly converting page, but it was a very popular page. And what we ended up finding is the people that were visiting that page were students who were doing projects on, say, some database work. And they were engaging us in lots of questions about these databases and things like that, but they really weren't prospects for us. So in our chat bot, we ended up having a path exclusively for them that said, are you looking for this? And if they were, we would direct them immediately to that, that content asset that gave them the information they wanted without necessarily taking up the time of our SDR team to engage in those conversations. You can also take a look at the live view. So you can see, you can keep it open, and you can take a look at who's visiting your site like throughout the day. And if you see some really top accounts that are visiting and you want to have a more proactive message to welcome them and engage them, you can do that. So I'm going to jump into some examples. We have just a couple minutes left. So I did want to show you some examples of kind of bringing this all together and bringing it to life. So here is one with a company called HexArmor. They are using display ads and email signature ads. For the purpose here is they wanted to kind of promote a new feature offering that they had, and it was specifically to their customers. So they were using it for customer retention and expansion. So you can see it's the same creative that they're using. It's the same messaging that they're using, but it's great to have that consistency. So they are targeting very specific accounts, and they want to make sure they see this message wherever they are on the web, but they're also seeing it in any outbound emails that's coming from the company. The next one is a company called Sock Telemed, and they're using ads, email, and chat. All three together. And they're using it again for new features or offerings to their customers. And this is with chat. In my previous slide, I didn't talk about it, but we have this functionality called Chat from Anywhere, where you don't have to be on our website to actually activate a chat conversation. So we can embed a link in any of these ads, either in the email or display, where if you click on it, it opens a chat window and you can have a conversation. So we're going to wrap this up quickly, about 30 seconds. This is another example from Dow Jones trying to promote an introduction for brand awareness, and they're using ads and email here in this example. And it's not exactly the same creative, but it's complementary. So sorry about the rush. This is another example using educational content. But what I wanted to do is I wanted to leave you with this. If you're interested in taking a look at this at more examples, please visit Terminus.com September issue 2021, and you can do that. Thank you.